Hi, Facebook. How are you? Invest in yourself and invest in your health. Today, I want to talk to you about three different types of water that's all I use to clean my face. Now, you're probably wondering why I look this way today. Well, I just finished running around in the shower. So now it's time for me to clean my face. As you can see, I'm in my house coat still. And I put my hair back, and I love this hairband. I just love peach. I love bright colors. I'm Lexi Hanna, and today I want to talk to you about the water that I use. Okay. I'm going to clean my face and tone my face with just water. Okay. Now, if you know anybody that wants to learn more about water, please share this out. Okay. Share this out to your friends. Go ahead. And please send me some emojis and make any comments that you'd like to make. Oh, I've already got some viewers. All right. Hey, Allison, Jarrett, Tom, thanks for hopping on, everybody. Gotta have my glasses off for cleaning my face. Okay, so if you're wearing a house coat when you clean your face, just tuck the collar in as I have. And that way you can clean from here up and you don't get your clothes all wet. Okay, so I'm going to flip the camera back and forth. Hey, thanks for the emojis. I'm going to flip the camera back and forth a few times during this demonstration, so please bear with me. And I'm going to show you now my containers of water. Okay, let me get that a little closer. All right, so on the left is 11.5 pH. I'm going to start with that in the middle, 2.5 pH water. That's a disinfectant. And the last one thing I'll do is use my 6.0 water, which is a toner. Okay? So I'm going to start. It's a little on the cool side, but that's all right. So, like I said, I was running around in the shower, and yes, it's a big shower. I washed my face with soap, but I wore makeup yesterday. I cleaned it off last night, but I just want to make sure that right now it's super clean. Because after this video, I will put my makeup on and get dressed. Got a little too much water on the cotton ball there, but that's okay. That's okay. And then I'm just going to dab my face dry. By the way, guys, there was a day when I would never jump on a go live without my makeup and hair done. This takes some courage. Okay. Next step, I'm going to flip the camera around. I've cleaned my face. And now I'm going to disinfect it with 2.0. Got some water on my cotton ball, cotton ball, the disinfectant water, 2.5. 2.5 disinfectant water. Thanks for the emojis. I think it's Jarrett. Thanks. Little too much water on my cotton ball. And as you can see, I like to do my neck with each step as well. It never hurts to clean, disinfect, and tone your skin on your neck at the same time, right? I don't know if you can see anything on there. I forgot to show you the first one. That's the first one. That's the second one. Like I say, I do clean my face with cleanser at night to get the makeup off. During the day, I do not sleep with my makeup on my face. I like that off my skin. And it's a lot healthier for your skin as well. Okay, so I've cleansed with the 11.5. I have disinfected with the 2.5, and now I'm going to tone my skin. This is the final step. Ready? Oh, I should show you that. So dipping my cotton ball into the 6.0, which is the toner water. And I'm back. This is the last step. Now, the water machine I have hooked up right to my kitchen sink makes all these waters, okay? I don't go to the store to get a cleaner or a disinfectant or a toner. I save a lot of costs in cleaning my face. And not only that, there's other uses for these waters, and I'll share that with you in a few minutes. Just gonna finish toning. My face feels nice and light and cool, so clean. The water is amazing. It doesn't take away wrinkles, unfortunately. Maybe one day they'll come out with a water that does that. That would be so cool. That's all right. Character lines. I'm a character and I've seen a lot in this world. Some good, some bad. Some of the bad I'd rather not see. But the good, I'd love to see it again. So there, I am done cleaning, disinfecting, and toning my face. Now, if you want more information about how you can get your hands on the machine that makes this water, please put in more info in the comments below. Put more info in the comments below. I am having a meeting later on today, and I'm having another info meeting on Friday, this coming Friday. And I'd love for you to join in, find out more about these waters, find out more about this machine that I'm talking about. And I'd love for you to join in with us and be part of our meeting. Like I say, there's one later on today, and there's another one on Friday. So just put more info in the comments below, and I will PM you. So I told you I was going to tell you more uses for this water, okay? So this machine also makes, okay, before I get to that, sorry, I jump around. When I showed you my pictures earlier in my timeline, I showed you how the water cleans off my veg. I do this over and over and over every time I bring home veg. And I use the 11.5 water, which I use to clean my face. Which is this one right here. Right there. 11.5. Like I said, I was going to jump the camera back and forth. So the 11.5 cleans your veg, cleans your countertops, cleans your face, clean anything in your house that you want it to clean. It's powerful stuff, and it comes right from your tap, okay? Now, the second one, the 2.5, the disinfectant, and I'll just remind you there, the one I disinfected my face with, right here. You can disinfect kids' cuts. People use it for their acne, to control their acne on their face. Any kind of wounds on your skin. I mean, it's just an overall disinfectant. And another beautiful part is you can disinfect your toilets, your sinks, your tubs, whatever you want to disinfect. It works wonderfully. So you see the versatility of this water? It can clean your skin, countertops. It'll disinfect your skin, your toilet. It'll clean your veg. I mean, it's so versatile. The versatility is crazy. I love having this water machine that's hooked right up to my kitchen sink. There's three different types of drinking water, 8.5, 9.0, and 9.5 pH. Okay, now I'm going to show you this. Got my little pH paper here. Hey, Sabira, thanks for hopping on. This is my pH paper here, okay? I've got some high alkaline filtered drinking water right here. By the way, all this water is filtered. Okay, this is my 9.5 filtered high alkaline water that comes out of my machine. I'm going to test it with my pH paper. Look at that. See that beautiful royal blue? It's higher than the scale, which it should be. My scale goes to, sorry, it's getting blurry there. On the end of my scale, it is 8.0. This is a royal blue. Look at it. It's gorgeous. I'm not sure why these pH papers can be different, but I'm going to show you. Well, okay, there's one obvious reason. The pH goes higher. So if you see 13 on there and you see the color of this paper, look at this. That's how high of pH this water is. Those last two are, okay, 11, 13 on the top, 12, 14 on the bottom. Hard looking in the camera and trying to figure stuff out on a scale and blah, blah, blah. Definitely 11. It's over 11. I mean, that's how powerful this water is. All from one machine, all from your kitchen tap. You don't have to leave the house. You can make all these waters that are so versatile right from your own home. It doesn't cost you anything. You don't have to run out and buy all these cleaners and disinfectants and toners. You can clean your house, your food. Oh, and did I mention my steaks? If I want to have a steak, I put it under my 11.5 water. I mean, under the tap if I'm in a hurry, or I'll fill the sink and I'll soak it for a few minutes in the 11.5 water. And again, I'm going to show you this. Right here, 11.5 pH water. Oh my God, when I first got my machine and I tasted the difference between a clean steak and a steak that was cleaned in just tap water, the difference was huge. Absolutely huge. If you love a good steak, you'll want to clean it with this water. A lot of restaurants have these machines that clean off their meat. You just soak it in for about 10 minutes. Soak your piece of meat, like your steak, roast, whatever you have, pork, if you like pork, put that in the water, soak it for about 10 minutes. The difference is phenomenal. We don't know what happens with that meat before we get it to our kitchen. We have no idea. We just hope and pray that the meat powers that be do it right. I don't know about you, but I mostly trust what I can do with in my kitchen. And then I know what I'm eating. I'm a lot more in control of what I'm eating, right? By the way, hospitals have this. Hospitals have this machine to clean and disinfect their instruments, to feed to patients. They use it for same amount of use, same uses as I do. Cleaning and disinfecting their tools, drinking water for their patients, cleaning the floors, cleaning the countertops, dishes, whatever it is. Thanks for the emojis. I think they're coming from Sabira. It is. Ah, freaking amazing water. It is. Totally Sabira. I even have a similar water machine hooked up in my shower. So why take just care of the inside of you? Why not take care of the biggest organ, which is your skin, right? So I have a machine in my shower, so I am getting beautiful shower via filtered, pure alkaline water. Well, wait a minute. I take that back. Filtered alkaline water. I have to be careful. The words that I'm supposed to use here, of course. And so, I mean, really, for pure, what are we talking? Mountain water? Straight out of the mountain. So, in my shower, I shower the biggest organ I have, which is my skin and yours. I shower with filtered high alkaline water. It's beautiful. It's awesome. It's soft. It's cleansing. And I just feel really good when I get out of the shower. So good. Thanks, Sabira. There was one other thing I wanted to share with you. What the heck was it now? Let me take a drink of my high alkaline water while I think a bit longer. That is good water. I found the city where I live and I asked what's in the water. What's in the tap water? What do you guys put in the tap water? And she rattled off probably 10 words that are this long. I think there was a whole bunch of syllables and then maybe a couple of vowels and then a whole bunch more syllables. I mean, I couldn't even write it down. What is that? So they have to pulverize it. They have to pulver. Municipalities are mandated to add in, I call it pulverize, natural water with all these chemicals to get rid of the bacteria. Okay, I can see that part. I mean, then we know there's a lot of bacteria and living creatures that come in from natural water, right? Especially when you watch your source. Riverbeds, whatever else is going into that river. I understand bacteria has to be controlled. Okay. However, the side of it I don't care for is this. They are also mandated to, thanks for the emoji, Sabira. They are also mandated to keep the water at 7.0 pH. Do you know why? I'll tell you why. They have to keep it at 7.0 pH because if they have it acidic, which is what it will be with all those chemicals, it rusts their city pipes. Then they got a big money problem. Then they got to change out those pipes all the time because they're rusting year after year after year. Very quickly, they're deteriorating because the water pumping through them 24/7 is acidic. You follow me? They're concerned about their pipes, not ours. Every city, every town mandated to have 7.0 pH. There was a place I lived once up in Hillbilly Hicksville up north, and I found out they were adding bleach to the water system. I could smell it. I'm like, why are you adding bleach? Because it kills the bacteria. Are you kidding me? Why don't you add something that's not so toxic or has that bad smell? Because that's the cheapest. That was my answer. That was my response, or their response to my question, because it's cheaper. Bleach, ladies and gentlemen, bleach. Really? Was freaking disgusting. I couldn't stand it. So I just bottled water in. I didn't know about this wonderful water machine that I have now, so I just carried the great big bottles of water into my house all the time. I'd bring in three or four at a time. I've always been a big water drinker. But now I don't have to carry water bottles in because I do have my own water machine in my house. It's on demand. I have my water, whatever water I want, when I want, which is a beautiful thing, and it's not costing me anything. Now, gentlemen, when I was talking about cleaning your face, don't be afraid to clean, disinfect, and tone your skin either. It's not just for us ladies, it's for you guys too. Let me see if there's any questions in the comments here. So they are really only protecting their freaking pipes? Exactly, Sabira. That's exactly it. No question. They will always tell you the water is safe to drink or boil it. Boiling really doesn't do anything. It's still bad water. But honestly, that is the only reason that they make our municipal water at a 7.0 pH is to protect their pipes. Because it would cost millions of dollars to always change out the water pipes because the water's flowing 24/7 and never stops, right? You got to flush your toilet on demand. You got to run your tap on demand. You got to clean your dishes. You got to do your laundry on demand. So that water's always got to be flowing and accessible through the pipes, the city pipes, municipal pipes, wherever you live. But yeah, they only do it to protect their bottom line, not ours. So it's us, up to us to look out for our bottom line, look out for our health. And that's why I said at the beginning, invest in yourself, invest in your health. It's extremely important. People go to the doctor and have problems. I talked to a nurse probably 10, 20 years ago. And I said, she was a nurse at the time for 25 years. She worked emergency. And I asked her, I don't know, the question just popped in my head. I didn't even know about this water machine that I have now. And I said to her, Marilyn, I said, what is the biggest complaint you see coming through emergency? And she goes, she thought about it for, I don't know, maybe 3 seconds. You know what she said? The biggest reason people are coming in to emerge is because of dehydration. That was profound to me. Because of dehydration. And there's an expert to ask. She's a nurse. She's been in eMERGE for 25 years. What more could you want for edifying someone? She's seen it all. The good, the bad, the ugly. She's seen stuff she never wanted to see in her whole life. She's seen stuff she probably couldn't even imagine. And she said the bottom line, reason people come in is dehydration. When you go to the doctor, especially here in Canada, they're not going to tell you, drink more water. You know what they're going to do? They're going to get out their writing pad and they're going to give you some chemical. That's what they do. But really, if you just went home and drank proper water, you'd be fine. Okay, no guarantees. Disclaimer, I'm not a doctor. I'm only going by my own experiences. And I'll retract that. I believe that if you drank enough of the proper filtered alkaline water, that your health would greatly improve from what it was. I believe you would feel better. I'm 58 years old. This is the water I drink. This is the water I use on my skin. This is the water I clean my face with. This is the water I clean my house with. I don't have to have shelves and shelves and shelves of cleansers in my pantry. And nor do I want it. The smells in the house are so toxic. The crap that they put in these cleansers is killer. Whew. Let me tell you, the older you get, the more your olfactory gets on fire, the less you can tolerate. I used to clean my oven with that oven cleaner. I'd be wearing a mask. I'd have gloves on. And I'm still just about knocked out. My eyes are watering. Woo! By the time I'm done cleaning up that oven, I'm just higher than a kite on that oven cleaner. No, I'm not ingesting it. That's just inhaling it. Oh. Hey, Michelle. Hey, right on. I'll PM you, Jarrett. Thank you. So this brings my go live to an end. I think I've been talking long enough to you today, guys. So I hope that I've given you value here. Again, please share this out if you know someone that needs to hear about good, high alkaline filtered water that you can have many uses for in your house and drink it, okay? Man, that's good stuff. I really appreciate you coming to the live. If you're watching the replay, thank you so much. Make a comment below if you want more info, either live or on the replay, that's fine. Again, we are having a meeting later this afternoon and on Friday, and I can give you, you can connect with me and I will send you a PM and send you the link, and you can join us in our more informational meeting about this great water. I'd love to see you there. Again, I'm Lexi. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate you. Have an awesome day. I will see you in tomorrow's video. Bye for now.